David.
Oh. Hey.
This is Eric. How are you, man?
Good, brother. How are you?
I'm good. Am I calling in the right moment?
Dude, I was totally forgot it was Thursday. But yeah, dude, let's do our thing.
That's the cool thing. It's kind of the new thing. Like, eh? I've got a fucking intro. Oh, that's right.
I was like, well, bet. I was like, what is this about? And I'm like, oh, fuck, I got an interview.
Fuck yeah, with me. Not with no one. With fucking Eric.
Yeah, you. What's up, my brother? What's happening?
I'm good, and you guys?
Dude, I'm really, really, really good. The video is doing great. The record's doing great. Tours are not stopping. Everything is going excellent.
Yeah, man. It's so cool, man. You know, and it's you know, after all those years, I think you reached the point where, you know, everything is fine.
Yeah. And you know what? I'm glad that we have a chance to talk, because that's also, it's like one of those things. It's like, I just feel like I'm in such a good position, in a good spot, and everybody, things are going. The world is a crazy spot, and things are up and down, but I've been lucky enough to be in this position, and I feel like lucky enough that I've grown up with the family and the friends and the punk rock family that I have to be in the position that I'm in right now, and to hopefully, you know, make some changes that need to be done. Not only like, I think in general, in the position you have as a singer or a songwriter in a punk band, we have an obligation to what we believe in, and to talk about it, and to say it, and to be upfront, to be honest.
It's fucking cool that you mentioned that, because we're at a strange era, you know, life's more fucked up than it never been. Not just politically, people are fucking fucked up, you know, with the internet, no more connection and everything. So the punk rock, you know, mentality is more, it's more accurate than ever. And I mean, most of the bands, they don't whine about political, they don't raise their voice like, you know, punk used to do. So I think the Casualties right now, and you guys, you know, we need you more than fucking ever. I mean,
well, this is why I feel this position was what it's funny that I'm in this position, because when I joined the band and I've been talking to people, well, how did it happen? What's going on? How do you guys get along? I've been on tour with these guys. I've known them for 17 years, and I'm from another band called the Crumb Bums. And we've been on tour all over the world together. And so when I got into this band, it's very well known that I talk about politics, and I'm kind of with my music, I believe that everybody deserves a right and to speak their mind. Like, how you cannot say that you and I both have not been wrong at one point in time in our life, you know?
Yeah.
And so I believe people need to sit down and have communication back and forth. However, when I'm writing my music, it's not so much I'm having a back and forth. I want to talk about where we stand. And I've always been somebody, I was taught this from my dad, that we stand up and we try to be a voice for people who do not have a voice. We try to stand up with the underdog, with people who can't take care of themselves, who people that need something. My father gave money for his work, gave grants to minorities all over the United States, and it bled on to me. And that's when we're talking in this new record, the new Casualties Written in Blood, it is a 100% political record.
And thank you.
Yeah. Sorry if I talk too much, but yeah, it's like, that's all I can say is that right now, I almost feel like right now, and I can tell with your voice too. Yes, we all like funny stuff, but right now, and this is me, I'm talking from my opinion. When you have a fucking mohawk, when you're fucking living this kind of lifestyle, and not just a mohawk, you know what I mean. You have to be political. Everything is political. You know, when people say, can we not be political right now? I understand what they mean, but there's no choice. Look at where right now, the United States, we have a laughing stock who is pretty much the most dangerous person in the world.
In charge.
Yeah. And we didn't vote for him. And it's kind of funny when you leave the United States sometimes, you'll get people that say, fuck you, you American, you're part of this. And I go, dude, I'm fighting against it. I'm fighting. I don't know how this happened, but it did. And it's like you said, this is the most fucked up person. Like this guy just thinks everything's funny. He thinks he thinks taking advantage of people is funny. He thinks murder is funny. He thinks rape is funny, and it's not funny.
Yeah, it's the joke. And it's not going to be fun, you know, when we going to know everything, because we don't know everything. And it's fucked up. And you said that, you know, and I think, you know, the reaction of most people, and in Canada, we were like, man, how people vote for him? Oh, it's not about the amount of vote. What? How does that fucking work? Oh, it's really complicated. And when you understand the system, it's, you know, it's just, okay, okay, if you have money, that's it, man, you gotta make it. If you're Bernie Sanders, you're fucked.
Exactly.
I mean, it's so ugly, and you know, I think we're at an era where I think there's more and more people that are waking up, and that's the reason I was saying you guys are more important. That's what you do, you know. A lot of kids go see you for the first time. They're young, and they see the messages, and they're like, oh, God, okay. You know, those guys are great. They think like that. I will do some research and, you know, make my mind on it. And it's the beauty of punk rock, but it's weird that most of the band, they don't choose that path anymore. And they're a less political band than ever.
Yeah, and I feel like right now, you know, in a few different ways, like we're saying, right now is the time to speak up. Right now is the time to say, fuck this president, fuck this wall, fuck these politics, you know, fuck everybody that believes in that. At this point in time, because, you know, and I've talked to older people and, you know, older, you know, in their 60s, and they say, well, you just don't understand. And part of me goes, no, here's the thing. It's not even me that's going to really hurt. It's like, you know, people that have kids right now, the kids right now, young kids are going to be the ones in the worst trouble. And old people, they want to keep money, and they still want that old way of life.
Yeah.
And the thing is, life is changing. 40 years ago, it was okay to be racist at work. I'm not saying it was, but that's how, you know, life was. People were racist.
The fact
people
was
there. Yeah, the fact was there. And they didn't think anything, well, that's just how things are. But that's not how we want it to be. And life is always evolving.
Yeah, and it can hit you in the face 20 years later. I mean, the Me Too movement really proved, you know, in the 80s, like, you know, pork, stupid fuckers who had money think they can, you know, rape anyone, any girl, anything they want, you know, but it's getting back to them now, you know, the Bill Cosby thing, you know, and it's, you know, there's hope. And I think that, you know, our generation, we were, you know, in the 90s, I'm 36, in the 90s, we were pissed off, and, you know, I mean, we were ready to put fire, and we have the band, the voice, everything was there, and then, clock, we got stuck in the system, and for a couple of years, we didn't do a shit, and we let that happen, and we, you know, got kids. I have a kid, but I think that some of us are waking up, and I think, you know, the rage are still there, and if there's, you know, if the right person will, yeah, at the right time, I think there's a couple of us that gonna wake up. I just want to go in the street
yes.
with the kids and just, man, do something. I just want to make something and change and leave something better for my kids. That's you know, that's the responsibility I think we all have.
That's 100% how I feel. And right now, I'm 40 years old, and I feel like the fire of like 18 year old. I want to be in the street. I want to, you know, I want to march with people. I want my voice to be heard. I want to scream with people that are hurting. And I want to, you know, here's the point. It's like, right now, what's going on with Kavanaugh and Ford in the politics right now? Some people, they just want to say, she's a liar. She's a liar. Okay, what if we listen to both of them? And the thing is, why are you so quick to just immediately say she's a liar? What does she have to gain off of this? And, you know, and it's one of these things. It's something that I want everybody to have their voice heard. Everyone deserves to be heard.
And the beauty of, you know, right now is that all of you that listening to the show and listen to Casualties interview, you can do something. It's not just making a band or doing a radio show. You can do whatever the fuck you want. Have a podcast and just talking. And, you know, we're at the era, you know, internet can really sucks, you know, Facebook and everything. But you can use that in a good way to spread a positive message and try to change things, you know. And that's what we do, I think. The connection, I mean, you know, it's different media. I do the radio show. I press play. I play you guys that sweating, creating. But at the end, we have the same goal, try to build something and change. You know, the mentality that stupid people have right now.
Well, another thing that I try to do is when you're in a band or, you know, you work in the media or some type of politics, people, they'll try to raise money or, you know, they try to make some type of event for politics, but it's real big and it makes people that are, you know, at home feel like they can't do anything. Well, I couldn't do this. It's too big. So one thing that I try to do is have a get together in your backyard and have everybody raise some money for something you believe in. Throw a small benefit. For us, we have somebody in, I live in Texas, and we have somebody that we're going for, you know, very, very open-minded, named Beto O'Rourke. And so I made t-shirts, and on the back, you know, we say how we feel. And the money from those t-shirts we give to the foundation, you know, for Beto. And that's the way I want people, young people, to realize you don't have to be a movie guy or in a band. You can just get together with a group of people and fight together and make, you know, make changes. You don't have to be, it doesn't have to be big, because every fire starts from a small spark.
It's true, and it's united that we can, you know, spread that fire, you know, almost everywhere, and it can be fast. And I think that the cool thing about the punk scene right now is there's not much money anymore. There's no money anymore. That's it. And I mean, everyone's doing it for the right reason, because it's in their blood. It's in your blood, like creating music, playing music, and, you know, sweat in front of people. It's you know, you're born for that. So, I mean, it's something you cannot fight. You know, it's in you. And people, you know, keep doing it and pushing their limits and their self and pushing music limits. And it's really beautiful, the connection right now with the scene, you know, Big Z. You know, if you're in a punk band and you think you're going to make it big, you're in the wrong scene at the wrong time, man.
You know what? If you think that way, it's, you know how sometimes I was just talking about this with people, and somebody told me, it was a friend of mine, and they've been working really hard, and they said, I just feel like I'm not going anywhere. And my response was, you cannot stop, because it's us that work so hard that, you know, it's just now that my voice is being heard more. If I would have stopped just because it was hard, then I have no right to be doing what I have. So sometimes, you know, I'm glad that it's hard. I'm glad that it's not easy to be in a band, because it weeds out the people that really don't give a shit. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, totally. And I mean, yeah. You know, Rise Against wrote a line that I love saying. They said, you know, when enough is enough, that's when you know that you're halfway there. And you all...
Yeah.
You know, it's always about, you know, pushing ourselves, you know. I mean, it's the same with the radio show. We had some really hard times and hard years, and, you know, every show we have to push ourselves, and it's all because of you, Ben, you know, that people, you know, stick to it. But, you know, at the end, it's totally worth it. It's all about being happy in what you're doing and what you create, and, you know, you are the master of it, you know. There's not much, you know, there's no people that can say, no, you owe me that, or, you know, you built your own fucking career, and that is so massive. It's so huge to do that. It's crazy, because I'm sure, David, if you remember the first time you get in the scene, if you know what the road were and how hard it is to get where you are now, I'm sure you would have said, oh, fuck it.
Yeah, and you know, exactly. But the thing is, too, it's like I always tell people, like, you know, when somebody says, they may say, I know this is weird, but I'm a fan of your music or something. I always tell people I'm a fan of the music that I get to play. Like, to be able to be in this band with these people, we're creating something, and it never gets old to me. I'm like every time we get up on stage to play, I feel like it's the first time, and it's the gift of punk rock, and it's the gift of playing for people with open-mindedness, and, you know, that we can get together after a show and talk, and we can agree and we can also disagree. But, you know, the idea is that we want a better tomorrow. We want a better future. We want to have a good time, but we also, you know, you said it, we got into this because we want something different. And I think that fire from the 90s is back, and it is about to explode again.
I think so. I feel it. And you're so right. You know, with the radio show, I see every type of, you know, band, hardcore, ska, and everything, and there's really something in the air. And everyone knows, you know, the band are fucking good. Even the new band, man, they release an EP there. It's just crazy, man. And, you know, it's the same thing when punk rock scene started up in the 80s. It was just too good. It was just a matter of time. So something's going to happen, and there's going to be another band, you know, that's going to do, like, maybe not the same way Nirvana did, but they're always, music is real, and there's always somebody that came with something that just blow everyone's mind. And that's the beauty of human being. You know, we can, together, if we unite, create something that, you know, overwhelm everyone, and even us, you know, and just, wow, and, you know, surf with that and have fun and create a lot of thing with that. And, you know, it's gonna happen. And I think we're at the right time, at the right place, and we make the good choice to not say, fuck it.
Yeah, well, you know, and that's why, like, right now, I feel I'm so happy about this new record with the Casualties, because when we got together, when you work with somebody new, so the other guys are writing with me, it also, it sparked a different way for them to write. So this is a very different, and I mean that in a positive way, but this, I feel like this record, it really has something to say, and it's got a new vibe. You know what I mean? It's like,
the line is there, you know, the Casualty line is there, but it's kind of different and so freshy. That's what I felt through the records. And what blows me up is, The chemistry behind you guys, you were a friend, you know each other, so there's something. But when people like me don't know that and don't know that chemistry, it's so wild to listen to it and feel it, because we feel you guys are having a blast. And I mean, that's the only way to release a great record and to have the time of your life, great time in studio, have great memories from that. And it's just something that is gonna follow you, because I have so many bands. I spoke with records they release, and sometimes they're like, "Oh God, I hate that record. It went so fast, and we were drunk and fucking, we were just arriving from the tour, hating each other. We want to kill each other." And we felt that, but man, fans are gonna, they want to hear that record too. So if you don't want to play it, just don't fucking release it. It's just. I always felt funny about that. Like, why did you fucking release? Oh, we got the record that's pushing us. But we're at the time. You can be the leader of what you release and what you do. So really something you enjoy doing it, and that you're gonna be proud in 10 or 20 years. But that record is a strong record. And I mean, I know it's kind of hard, stepping shoes from somebody that's been in the band for a long time. But that's the cool thing right now. People are really open-minded about it, because so many bands, it happens, and people get it more. So they're not like judging, everything you do. They just want to, embark, in the ride. So I think it's cool. And, again, I repeat myself, but you guys know each other. We see that you're close friends. So you were, part of the family anyway. So it was natural, I think.
It was very natural, and there was a little bit inside of me that I think why I was able to take this position and have a good time with it was because this was all by accident. I stepped in to play one show. It went really well, but what I kind of told the guys and or I asked them and we all agreed. I said, I don't want to be in like doing karaoke. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to be singing somebody else's music because for my life. So I said, if we can write a new record all together, we all agreed. If we're going to do this, we need to write a new record. And within, this is no joke, within 6 months of me joining the band, we wrote, what I feel is an incredible record, and we all feel like this could be one of the best records we've ever written in our lives.
I think so. I did the records, and it's like I said, it's something that came from the heart, and it just it's a right record. I mean, it's not reinventing the wheel, but it's the right record that you have a blast listening to it. And listen to the whole record, god damn it. There are people that just listen to a couple of songs. Records have many songs. You press play and you listen the whole thing. Listen to it, the whole records. I mean, I like it because there's so many records that slow down at the end, but you guys is just prime time from start to end. It's just even, the last songs are just crazy. It's really, it has a really good impact.
The last song, it was again because I was joining a band that's much bigger and I had a larger platform of people to speak to when I write. And I said, we got to end this fucking record with a fucking kick to the political system's fucking balls, and we got to kick it as fucking hard as we can. So I don't want to, I don't, I'll save it for people to hear, but at the end of this record is just where I felt like I could just really tell Trump and these fucking assholes to go fuck themselves.
And it's so priceless. But we're stuck with, Justin Trudeau is not the best either. He's making really, really bad decisions for all Canada. And I mean, right now we're at the Quebec election, and it's funny because there's four parties, and one of them are more, how can I say, more anarchist or anything. And nobody cares about them, but right now there's a wind of change. and people really, you know, went to them, and it just, there's something happening in Quebec too. But you know, we got the legalization of marijuana, which is a kind of joke because it's a false legalization. They're not really legalized because you cannot smoke anywhere. It's illegal to smoke it anywhere, and there ain't gonna be no coffee shop. So you smoke it at home, but if you rent the place, the owner can say, no, you don't smoke in my, you know, apartment. So at the end, you cannot smoke anywhere. You can buy legally weed, but you cannot smoke it. It's a joke, man, and people realize
It is,
it.
though.
And when you said with Trump, it's a joke. That's the thing. It's the joke. And we're at the era that everyone is laughing in our face, but now it's just, okay, I get it. They're laughing in my face. So that's gonna be interesting for the next, 10 years.
Yes, yeah, there's going to be, it's interesting too, because like you said, me and you are a little bit older than some of the kids, but I wonder what is going to be in the history books.
Yeah,
You
me
know,
too.
what is it, what are they going to say? What the,
It's
you
not gonna
look
be
back.
the
Yeah, it never is. And here's one other thing, that these the school systems and politics, they tell you what they want to tell you.
Yeah.
So right now in history books for kids, they say, well, Columbus came over and the Indians welcomed them, and then they jump 100 years. They don't tell you that, like, the Columbus and the Spaniards and the
Fucking
settlers,
rape
they
their women, steal
all,
them, steal their food, their land, and everything. They don't talk about it. And kill them brutally. Like, hey man, hey guys, we want to make friends. We don't see a lot of people. We want to smoke some. Yeah. Oh, we're gonna kill them and rape that woman. Great guys. Yeah. You know, America was built on crime.
On murder. And see, I'm Mexican, and my family on my dad's side is from Mexico, and you right now they just say, well, go back, go back. Well, at one point in time, this was all Mexico.
Yeah.
Texas was
Go
Mexico.
back. You guys go back. It's our land. What the fuck? You know,
Yeah,
when you discover
exactly.
the real history, it's kind of piss you off. And that's the thing. I love to learn and I love history and I read a lot about that, but it pissed me off and it affect me. Really. I mean, I think about it at night and it really affects my
Yeah, that's the
mood,
thing.
man. It just sometimes it's
It'll
hard to
keep you up
read.
all night long.
Yeah,
Yeah, all night
thinking
long.
about
You have to.
You know, it's
Exactly. What happened? What happened?
what the fuck? Yeah, how can human let that, you know, flip out so bad? And even things we don't know, but we can imagine them now, you know, we know.
Yeah. All we can do now is just honestly fight for just a better tomorrow, and just like I said, give everybody a, let's have a chance to talk, not this fucking bozo that's making jokes and trying to kick people out of the United States, and just sit down, calm down, and let people talk. We need to find out what people need. What, you know what I mean? What do you need to find happiness? Where can we take racism and sexism and homophobia out of our world, so that when we have kids, their kids don't even know what racism is? That's what I think, that's what our goal, me and you, people like us, we want. I want kids to never know what, you don't want people to not remember, but just not have it in their life.
Yeah. You know, be proud of our generation because we stand up. That, I mean, if we
Yeah.
can do that, and you know, it's all about change and we can make it. It just, you know, we have to be connect together more than ever and not on Facebook, God damn it. You're not connect on Facebook. Shit.
Exactly. That, and one other thing too with that is that this is the new mental problem. It is a real serious mental disease, because instead of me living my life, I have to create a fake world. And when people realize that their lives are fake, it's only on the internet, they go into a depression. So everybody is depressed. Everyone has anxiety. Everyone is scared to go outside because they created a fake world that only exists on their telephone or on the computer.
It's true. It's all about the image right now, like looking good.
Yeah.
And, you know, on Instagram, it's, you know, you have to be half naked looking good. It's just, it's not the reality.
Yeah.
It's really not the reality. And you're right. We're going to have so much case of people killing themselves of depression just because of, you know, internet. And kids, you know, it's just, it's fucked up, man. And we let that happen. It's just, it's not normal.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all about,
it's not normal.
Yeah, it's sharing, you know. Explain them, tell them. You know, if you don't spoke to them, of course they will never know.
Exactly. And, you know, it's right now there are kids, and it's kind of cool to see happen. Kids are saying, we don't want everything to be on the computer. There's kids now that they don't want to watch all this porno because, you know, they see so much that they don't care to have a relationship, you know, and it's like you remember when you first started dating somebody and you had your first, you know, kiss or your first sexual experience or something. Now a kid is 7 or 8 and he's watching the craziest porn ever.
That's true. It's fucked
up. You know, it's just wild.
It's so wild. But, you know, I think in a way we're writing history and music and we don't get it, but there's something's going to happen. And, you know,
yeah,
as long as we're trying something, we're in it.
It's happening. And it's like this, it's as much as kind of we talk about, you know, the things that are wrong, there's a lot of stuff that's going on right now. People are standing up for what they believe in. People are helping each other, you know, and I always try to like tell people don't forget all the good stuff too. There's tons of great stuff. And, you know, and it's like, put down your phone, put down your computer and spend some time with your friends, go outside, do something, because there's good stuff happening all the time. But it's hard to see when you stay inside and you only look at the computer.
It's true, man. Anyway, as long as you guys keep, you know, writing good songs and playing music, we're there, man. And, you know,
yes,
thank you so much.
Yes, that's the way.
And
you
know,
got it, brother.
The Writing in Blood People is going to be released on October 26th, if I'm right.
Yes, you are right.
I didn't write anywhere because I've got the 26th in my fucking head.
Yep, October 26th on Cleopatra Records, and we will be coming on tour with Goat Horn, and we'll be in Canada, the United States, and we're going to be touring over the next year, so we really look forward to seeing everybody and, you know, having a good fucking show and rocking out and getting to talk to each other.
And it's going to be crazy because it's funny, you're going to be in Quebec City with the tour. But you've been in Quebec City a month ago with the Leftover Crack.
Yes. Yes, I was. And I had a great time. And you know what was really cool? It was good because a lot of people were telling me, I'm excited for this new record. I'm really more people than I kind of had expected, because it was kind of a surprise to all of us that I was with Leftover Crack. But after every show, people were telling me, hey, we're really looking forward to the new Casualties record. And I think it was a really good introduction to say hello to people.
And that's cool, you know, because you've been in so many shoes and fucking nail it. That's the beauty of it. I've got so much great comment about the show. People were really surprised, and that's the thing, you know. No one knew how it's going to be. And I'm sure you guys didn't know, too. And it's, you know, it's pure to see the reaction of people. And from what I saw, people were having a blast. And, you know, they get it, you know, sing the songs and
they had a great time.
You know, the crowd is the most important thing in a show. You know, you create the show, mm-hmm. and you give the energy to the band. And that's what happened, I think.
That's exactly what happened. And, you know, it was one of those things of the reason there is a show, there even is a show, is because people want to be there. They want to support the band. They want to sing with the band. So my thing is, I always get the microphone and I go out with people and we sing together, because, you know, there's a lot of people that knew those songs better than me. So because Sturgeon couldn't be there, I let them sing and we sang together, and it made a good situation out of a bad situation.
That's true. Always try to find a positive. Yeah. And it was, exactly. It was cool, man. And thank you, man, for doing it. And, you know, it's
always,
I always call them, you know, the one time, one shot. You have to be there to live that. And I miss that. Shame on me, but I'm going to be there. With you guys at the Casualties, that tour means a lot to me. It's such a great band, and I know you all, you know, close friends. So it's going to be a huge family thing, man, and, you know, it's going to be great to have you back in Quebec, man.
Yep, I can't wait to meet you, brother, and, yeah, we'll see you soon.
Fuck yeah. Until then, go buy the new records. We need them to tour, and they need gas, so they need money. And, man, thank you so much, David. And, you know, say thanks to everyone in the band, and I to everyone in the band. We're going to do a huge special on the Casualties and play
thanks.
Tons of tracks of the new record. So make sure I'm going to send you the link. I'm going to send you the podcast, but we're not a podcast show. We're broadcast in studio, the first French-Canadian radio in North America.
Oh, great.
Crazy
oh,
shit.
Oh, man.
And
that
yeah, that's cool. That's
so
cool that they let me doing
crazy,
it for 10 years. That's the cool thing. They're crazy.
Yeah, they're crazy. They're crazier than you.
Yeah, that's what I told, man. I'm not the craziest one. They let me do it. So, you know.
Yeah.
So, man, until we met at the time of your life, thank you so much for your energy, man. I had a blast, man. It's so cool to talk to real human being and people that are really open-minded and intelligent, and you guys are all about that. So Casualties, thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Thank you, brother, and I'll talk to you soon.
Al, yeah, see you in Quebec City. Go grab tickets. My friend, thank you so much, brother.
Later, brother. I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Hell yeah. Beer's on me tonight. Send me the bill.
You got it.
Cheers.
Bye.
Bye.